Good morning. This is All India Radio Kohima. The morning news read by Jonas Yantan. Indian and Chinese militaries will hold another round of Lieutenant General level today in an attempt to de-escalate tension in eastern Ladakh. The meet will also finalize modalities for disengagement of troops from the sensitive region. It will be the third round of Lieutenant General level talks, and sources said it will take place in Chosul sector on the Indian side of line of actual control. The meeting is scheduled to start at 10:30 a.m. The Indian delegation at the talks will be headed by 14 Corps Commander Lieutenant General Harinder Singh, while the Chinese side is likely to be led by the commander of the Tibet Military District. The first two meetings had taken place at Molto on the Chinese side of the LSE. In the second round of talks on 22nd of June, the two sides arrived at a mutual consensus to disengage from all the friction points in eastern Ladakh. Official sources said the two sides are expected to deliberate on the implementation of an agreement arrived at the first round of the Lieutenant General talks on June 6th. Nagaland School Education Department is collecting data through district education officers for the Unified District Information System for Education UDISC+. Principal Director of School Education, Shanawas C, said soft copies of data collection format have been already sent to schools. He said that earlier many school heads provided inflated and inaccurate data without proper application of minds. The principal director directed heads of schools under the state and central government and private managements functioning within Nagaland to devote enough time to understand the meaning of various parameters being used in the UDISC+ format. He cautioned that accountability will be fixed at all levels of data collection, and furnishing of inaccurate or incomplete data would lead to closure, derecognition, or withdrawal of NOC of schools. The Food Corporation of India has said sufficient stock of food grains is available with it. FCI procured total 388.34 lakh metric tons wheat and 745.66 lakh metric tons of rice till June. As per FCI's latest report, it currently has 266.29 lakh metric tons rice and 550.31 lakh metric tons of wheat. About 55 lakh metric tons food grain is required for a month under National Food Security Act and other welfare schemes. Since the lockdown, about 138.43 lakh metric tons food grains have been lifted and transported. Centre has banned 59 mobile apps which are prejudicial to sovereignty and integrity of India, defence of India, security of state and public order. Electronics and IT Ministry said in a release that these apps were banned in view of information available that they are engaged in activities which are prejudicial to sovereignty and integrity of the country, defence of the country and security of state and public order. The banned apps include TikTok, Hello and WeChat. Over the last few years, India has emerged as a leading innovator when it comes to technological advancements and a primary market in the digital space. At the same time, there have been raging concerns on aspects relating to data security and safeguarding the privacy of 130 crore Indians. It has been noted recently that such concerns also pose a threat to sovereignty and security of the country. Union Minister for Atomic Energy and Space, Dr. Jitendra Singh, has said that the launch of India's first human space mission, Gaganyaan, will not be affected by COVID pandemic, and preparation are carrying on in the right direction. Dr. Singh informed that even though the training of four Indian astronauts in Russia had to be halted due to the pandemic, but the department had kept a contingency cushion period both in the training program and launch deadline. He said the training of astronauts has now been resumed and the launch is scheduled to take place as planned before the 75th anniversary of India's independence in 2022. Speaking about Chandrayaan 3, India's lunar mission, Dr. Singh said it is planned for launch next year. He said a mission will involve a lander, rover and a propulsion system to carry the modules to move, but would not have an orbiter as the previous orbiter is fully operational. With that, we end the morning news. Have a nice day.